Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Lydia's Crafty Corner with me, Lydia, in my little crafty corner. So today we're going to be creating this card, which features a beautiful kind of watercolor spotlight image that we have on the front of the card, as well as a little bit of shading using some colored pencils too. So I am going to be using the very pretty Painter Flower Camellia, and I'm going to be using this image a number of times on the front panel. So I'm working onto a piece of watercolor cardstock, and it's 4 by 5 1/4. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this image here and I'm going to multiply stamp it all over this panel. So I'm just going to stamp this using some embossing ink. Now I have already used some anti-static powder on that panel. And when I do embossing onto watercolor cardstock, I like to stamp the image twice. That's why I do tend to use my Misti when I'm doing it onto watercolor cardstock. Because the cardstock isn't very smooth, it's got a bit of texture to it, I want to make sure that I've got that ink down perfectly before I do emboss it. The embossing powder that I'm using is the Rose Gold embossing powder, and it is very, very pretty. So I'm kind of stamping this 4 times into each of the corners, and then I had a little bit left over at the top, so I just added in a couple more of the berries there. If you do get stray embossing powder on the panel, just make sure that you do brush that off with a dry paintbrush before you heat set it. Now I'm going to add a little bit of a border to this panel. Now I'm doing 1/2 inch, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the little grid lines that are on my cutting mat behind me to line up the little squares that I need to tape off. Now with this masking tape, you're going to want to make sure that you do press this really firmly down, because we don't want any of the watercolor to go underneath this. So once I'm done with that, I can then start my watercoloring. Now for this kind of watercolor, when I'm trying to keep it within the border that I have there with the masking tape, I do tend to do a drier watercolor than I normally would. So I'm trying to make sure that I don't have too much on my brush when I do go up to that edge piece, because I want to make sure that nothing goes under that tape. I'm using the 24 pan set from Altenew. This is my favorite watercolor set. And I did go with the leaves first. Reason being, I didn't really know what color I wanted my flowers to be at this point. So I'm just using a mix of that beautiful olive green color with a little bit of brown for the leaves. And I'm then going with a pink and a purple mixed together for the berries. It was at this point that I decided that I was going to go for some really bright yellow orange flowers. So I'm just going to add a wash of that really light yellow that I've just mixed down. I can then take some more of that yellow in more of a deeper tone, and I'm just going to add that to the base of all of the petals. This is going to give me a really great shading, and as we have that kind of wash of the light yellow down, or even a little bit of clean clear water, it's going to kind of drag that color out towards the edge of the petal, but it is going to fade out more and more, so you're going to get a really dark base of the petal and then a really pretty light kind of petal tip. I really am loving how bright and vibrant these yellow flowers are, and it is making me think of spring, which I very much need at the minute. So I'm going to keep going with the flowers just to make sure that they're all the same. So that really light yellow first, and then the darker yellow orange to the base of the petals and where they fold over each other. So once I did all that, I then decided I wanted to make more of a spotlight. So to do that, I decided to add a background. So I'm just going to be using the really dark blue from this watercolor set. Whichever dark color that you do have would work, and you could even use black. Once this background was finished, I then let it dry, and then I could move on to some more shading. So what I'm using is the watercolor pencils from Altenew, and this is the orange cream, and I'm just kind of scribbling that in to the darker places that I want, and kind of then moving that around with my finger just to blend it out a little bit. They do work really, really well this way, and I do find that smudging them really does help move them into the paper a little bit more. So once I have the orange in there, I'm then just going to add some of that Shadow Creek, and I then added some yellow ochre to those greens just to darken those up a little bit more. Once I'd finished with the little leaves, I'm then going to add a little bit of color to those berries, and I did go with ruby red, although thinking about it, I should have gone with a purple. Once that's all been done, I can then remove all of the masking tape from around the edge of this panel. And I just love how this looks. So you have that really bright and vibrant centerpiece, and then that just that gold embossing on white around the edges. So I'm just going to add this onto a card base, which is 4.25 by 5.5, and I've just used some wet glue for that. The sentiment is from the Circled Sentiment stamp set, and I just stamped that onto some white cardstock using some obsidian, and I'm going to be using some of the beautiful antique gold thread just to add behind this sentiment, just to make it pop a little bit more and maybe pull it in a little bit more with the rest of the card. I really do think that this little bit of texture really does make a huge difference to the card. So here is the card complete. I really do hope that you like the card and that you've enjoyed the video as well. If you do create a card that was inspired by this, it'd be great if you do share it, because we would love to see. Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and we'll see you again really, really soon. Bye-bye. Hello there, crafty friend, Lydia here. Just popping in to say that you can get your daily dose of crafting tips, techniques, and tutorials just like this by subscribing to the Alternew YouTube channel. All you need to do is click on that little bell up there and you will never miss a video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.